Hello, my name is Laurits Sørensen. I'm the CEO of a company called Microshade. Microshade produces a new breed of solar shading technology that you integrate into the glazing. And my question to the panel is, our technology is fairly costly initially to buy, but it has a very high, low ROI, so very good TCO, total cost of ownership. So your advice, we have technology vendor, we have proven technology, we've sold for a while. What would be our penetration point? Because I'm changing my strategy in my home market now to actually go directly to building owners, because I don't see anybody really driving, picking up my technology and really pushing it into market, even though we can clearly demonstrate that this is a very sensible and the right investment to actually do in the long run. So we've talked to contractors, we've talked to architects, and we've talked to, and the whole market, I don't really think is facilitating these kind of technologies being pushed into the market. So of course I have some ideas, and now we're going directly, but I'd really like to hear what do you think our penetration point should be in order for us to engage into the market.
To make it more useful, we've got integrators, retail energy providers, we've got architects and ESCO type companies on the panel. Is there any particular firm that your company is targeted at as a partner? Is it energy companies? Is it
That's my question, because we're working more or less with anybody, and it's not moving as quickly as a venture company would like. And that's also why I'm now actually engaging directly in my local market. I'm going directly to the building owners, right. And that is starting to kick off, because we go directly to them, we can prove a clear value proposition, and then we actually bring the contractors into those deals. But it seems strange that you're sitting with a technology and me as a small company needs to engage building owners myself when everybody talks about this trend, and it really makes a lot of sense in order for us to push this forward. So actually I want to ask across the board
to everybody,
who would pick up a technology like ours who has proven itself, drives clear results, and is a really sensible investment in the long run.
Okay. Anybody would like to respond? How long, out of interest, is the payback period for your technology?
So at the moment, we are not selling into residential. We are primarily selling into non-residential solutions. And it depends on the exposure of sun, of course. But it comes between 4 to 5 years and up to 12, 15 years.
Okay.
But if you look at it, it's actually, with the companies we talk to, the direct customers we talk to, that's actually well within their normal return on investment on doing these things. And one thing you need to remember, the primary reason for them going in this direction is just to finance a reason to have a greener profile on their lease contract. Because many of these buildings, they're simply not able to lease themselves because of the energy profile. So the main benefit for them is of course that they can fully finance it, that's great, but the main benefit is that they can actually lease out the contract.
Okay. So look, we're running short of time, so I'm conscious of two things. The first is, there's one further question that a couple of members of the panel wanted to talk about, and we've had one question from the floor. So I think, given that we started late, if it was fair for us to have an extra 5 minutes before we wrap, anybody else from the floor who has a question, and Blas and Gonzalo have a couple of final remarks on financial and operational aspects of this market, if not. So, anybody else have an issue that they wanted to raise before we turn to that final question? Okay, well, the barriers, policy, financial, operational, which we've talked about quite a lot in the panel. I want you, Blas, and then following to close, Gonzalo, to make some final remarks on those.
Yeah, I'll be really...
With fixed prices. So it sounds a good model to develop. Yeah? That's all.
Thanks. I know that all of us have more to say, because this is an issue which not only a big market, but as you can tell from the comments of the panel, it's got large companies involved, and there's a lot of challenges yet to solve. Venture capital and clean tech is a part of that solution, and hopefully that you will all take the opportunity to connect directly with any of these panelists in the break that we're now going to have. And thank you to everybody. We did it on time. I have to say that this session was not the reason for why we're now 15 minutes delayed. But thank you so much for your attention. Thank you to the panel. Thank you, Yamina, for your speech, and thank you to you all for listening.